Let's see if we can get a little song going for you here. So I add an instrument, and actually let's do the smart keyboard first. And I like the autoplay on this, and you have the bottom, you have some different keys here, and these are actually just the root of the note. So this is just the C and different octaves in every four beats. I guess there's a little five there. The top half is sort of the treble side. If you do both, then you get sort of the fuller sound of the piano. If you, instead of hitting both two fingers, you can just hit the top one and that selects both. And let me change my chords here. So I'm gonna edit chords. And now with this F to be a D. So I have G, C, and D. Let me see if I like this one. How does number three sound? Yeah. Four's kind of nice. I'm gonna do just the top. I don't want the bass notes. So let me start. So this is eight bars, and I'll do G, C, and D. And I am hitting the note slightly before the beat happens. So I'm hitting it like right before. 5/4, 6. I hit it now. Now it changes on the measure. Yeah, I kinda like this though. This is a nice, neat little sound here. So let me stop it and I'll go to instruments and add a bass to this because I like to hear my bass. And we'll pick the upright bass. And let's see what he can autoplay for us. Let's see what one is. So I'm gonna hit play and see how that sounds with it. Eh, that's not too bad. Let's see what the other one is, like three, all seems to be good. Quite fit on this one. I'm gonna try and see this pass if I like it. Actually, I'm gonna go back to number one. I like number one. So I'll hit stop. I'm gonna drag my slider back over. You can just hit this button up top, and that'll take you back to one. So let me hit record, and I add this bass track with it. And I'll go G again right before C, right before I hit D, and I hit G. And I hit it kind of late there, so it sounded a little off. And then I hit it now, and I hit it now. And let's see how this sounds. Nice little background. So I didn't like how that one measure four turned out. So I'm going to stop it, and let's re-record it. So I'm going to hit record, G, hit before, and before, and then before. There, it sounds better. And I don't touch G, I let it go. I hit C, my D, and then my G. And there's a nice, good, full sound, little ensemble here. Bass and piano duet. And so far, all I've had to do is tap G, C, D, G in the right order, and the autoplay does the rest of it for me. Let's add some strings just because that's me and you guys know that. So, autoplay dials over here, and you have some different options. So, if I hit cinematic, let's try modern and kind of see what. That's a little rough for me. Still rough. That's fun and kind of light. I don't know if that's gonna fit with mine. Maybe four. Let's hit play. And then it's a little much. bench. Let me go back to cinematic. And I'll hit when it gets back around the top here. Something else you can do with the strings here, if it's too much, I'm not looking, there's a lot of it, because I already have a bass, so I'm going to tap on bass, and it'll actually make him go dim, and I won't hear the basses. I'll take the cellos out and just kind of leave the high strings. Let's try romantic. I'm just not finding the one I like here. Yeah. Let's see, that's three. That's kind of nice. Let's go. I'll fade in there. Yeah, it's okay. I'm still not crazy about it. Maybe a pop one. Nope. Not that one. Let's try that. So I'm on pop finally. Autoplay one. Let me see what this is like. That's the sound I like. So I'm gonna record this one. All right, 1, 2, 3, and G. And I hit her before, C, and I hit before, and then back to G. I leave G, go to C, D, and then back to G. I like this. There's no drums in it right now. There's a voice or samples. You can do some other fun stuff with the other ones, but I kind of like how this is at. So, if you want, you can change some different levels. If you want to add some echo or reverb, you can do that here. I don't necessarily want to do that. What I think I'd like to do, let's go back to my songs. I'm going to hit select, I'm going to tap on it, it'll highlight it, and then I'm going to hit the square with the arrow coming out the top, and I'll share it. So I'm going to send this, let me just email it to myself, and then I can put it on my laptop. Let's see, artist, composer, album. Sounds good. So that's going to email it, it's going to open up in the mail app, and I can send it. It said, I made a song with GarageBand, and I will send it to myself. And then you don't have to type anything else if you want to. And that's called My Song. If you want to change the name of your song, you can tap on the words My Song. You can change it, and this will be Russell's song instead. So that's you. You can share it. So that's just a quick little light song that I made there. So what I'd like you to do is to try and make a song. Pick two or three instruments. Use the autoplay. Use the smart drums, smart guitar, smart bass. And try it out. Use those three chords that we did and have some fun. Try and do some different things and see what sounds good to you and what you like.